Half a day, students. My name is Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio. As we battle this COVID-19 outbreak, I want you to know that together, Governor Liu and I are working very hard to do everything within our power to keep our island safe from COVID-19. In addition, we have been working closely with the Guam Department of Education and PBS Guam to bring you continuous educational curriculum while you stay home during this time. With that said, Governor Liang Guerrero and I want you to remember to stay safe. This means listening to your parents. Wash your hands for at least 20 seconds and wash your hands frequently. Together, we will get through this. To our parents, the governor and I know how important it is that we stay diligent in our efforts to keep our students of Guam healthy and safe. Thank you for stepping in with your child's education during this time. I would also like to thank each and every member of the Guam DOE team, teachers and support staff, for their hard work, boundless energy, and for their commitment to our students of Guam. To our students, we hope that you enjoy PBS University while at home. Have a great lesson.
PBS University is a program by the Guam Department of Education, PBS Guam, and in conjunction with public school teachers to create lessons that students will be able to easily follow. With the aim of helping students continue their learning at home, providing both parents and students with a unique educational experience. PBS University on PBS Guam.
Half a day, my name is John Fernandez, Superintendent of the Guam Department of Education. I want to begin by thanking you all for staying home and staying safe during the current COVID-19 pandemic. Let's continue to do our part by practicing good hygiene, social distancing, and staying home. I know it's not easy, but we can do this. Remember, we are all in this together. I know you understand why we had to close schools down for the rest of the school year, and I want you to know that your safety, the safety of your families, and the safety of employees come first. But let's not give up on teaching and learning. As you know, we have already provided a set of distance learning resources that are now on our website at www.gdoe.net. Now we're taking it to the next level with the help of Guam Public Broadcasting Service, better known as PBS. We will be launching PBS University, which will contain televised weekly lessons developed by our teachers and staff for students from K-12. These will be simple but effective lessons for students to work on at home, and they will include lessons in reading, math, and character development. These lessons will be updated weekly for the remainder of the school year and into the summer. Students, here's your opportunity to keep your mind sharp while you're stuck at home over the next few weeks. And parents, I hope that this will assist you in providing your children with dedicated instructional time and support. I want to close by just thanking those people on the front lines of the COVID-19 fight, our healthcare professionals, including our very own DOE school nurses and social workers, our law enforcement professionals, including our very own DOE student attendance officers and school resource officers, our principals and school staff, who along with Sodexo employees serve 24,000 school meals to feed our island's children, our food and nutrition employees, who are delivering food supplies to our nonprofit and government partners to assist needy families, and our teachers and staff who have worked hard to make distance learning a reality. Finally, a message to students. Keep a positive attitude. Keep learning. We miss you, and we'll see you soon in the new school year. Siduos maasi, and stay safe.
Hi, everyone. It's Miss Cruz, your friendly neighborhood middle school teacher. I'm here today to give you a lesson in character education. What specifically in character education? Well, I'll be giving you a lesson on perseverance. What is perseverance? Well, perseverance is when you keep doing something, even if it's really difficult, and you keep going till you get better or you succeed. So a really simple way of saying that is basically to never give up and keep going. So you may not know it, but you practice perseverance a little bit every day. An example is when the Wi-Fi goes out, right? You're gonna do anything you can to make sure that goes back on because you wanna watch your YouTube or get back to playing your games, right? So you're gonna go to your parents, see what's up, or you might reset the router yourself. So this is an example of the challenges you face in life or in school where you need perseverance to get through the challenges. Here are some more examples.
First, I'm going to be showing you different situations where I will need perseverance in order to complete my task or get through them. The first situation I'm showing you is me trying to solve a math problem. I'm really struggling here. Hopefully I can get through it. Next, I'm going to practice or try to learn the floss, which I can't seem to get down. Lastly, I've been trying to learn a new skill. Here, I'm trying to learn archery. But I have no teacher. I wonder if I'll ever be able to learn. It's so hard to pull back the string and to get the arrow to stay. Oh no, I missed. I guess I'm giving up. Oh no, this isn't a good example of perseverance. Miss Cruz, get it together.
When you feel like giving up, you gotta tell yourself, you can do it. Just keep going. Just keep swimming, just keep swimming, swimming, swimming.
With perseverance, it's key that you motivate yourself. No one else can motivate you to do better and do your best but you. So here I am. I will solve this math problem. I will learn the floss eventually. I still have a long way to go, but I'm getting there. I will improve my archery. Look how much better I look already.
Now, how can you build perseverance? Well, that's easy. What you gotta do is set goals for yourself and actually stick to them. So an example of a goal you can set is that if you always wanted to read a chapter book, set a goal to read one chapter a day. Or you can set a goal to memorize the multiplication table. Or if you wanna get better at your free throws, shoot 10 in a row. So these are some examples of little goals you can set for yourself. And it's okay if you get frustrated and need to step back a little bit when you're doing these goals. As long as you go back and you finish them, because that's what perseverance is, right? So perseverance is important to face all these challenges in life, whether it's in your personal life, in school, or your future career. Now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna give you a little activity you can do at home that kinda helps you practice perseverance. And it's really simple, and all you need is these materials, which is 3 cups with the same height, and then 3 butter knives. So what you're gonna do using these cups and knives is you lay it out like this. So as you can see, the cups are evenly spaced by having the knives placed in between. So what your job is during this activity is to figure out a way to create a bridge that connects the 3 cups together. So that's all for today. I hope you have fun with that activity. Bye-bye.
Today, my name is Ava Lujan, reporting from my house for Nutty News. Today, I will be showing you how I stay active. Let's go!
First, I get into a butterfly pose and try and make my head touch my feet. And then, I get into a pipe hold and try and make my hands touch my toes. After that, I get into a lunge. Then, I go down and grab my foot. And do the same thing on the other side. Next, I hold a plank for 20 seconds. After, I do 10 jumping jacks, then 5 push-ups. Then I go right, left, down, left, right, down. Next, I try and hit 10 bumps. I do a little twirl, for no reason, just having fun. After that, me and my mom play some volleyball, but a different way. We bounce it and then hit it. Instant replay. Again, this is Ava Luhong reporting for Nenny News. Thanks for watching. Adios.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mrs. Palomo, and I'm a reading teacher at FB Middle School. This video is going to be about literacy. More specifically, I'm going to be going into making inferences. But before we move on to our lesson, let's go over the vocabulary word of the day. The vocabulary word of the day is engross. Engross is a verb that means to absorb all the attention or interest of. Here are two sentences using the word engross. Sentence 1. She was too engrossed by her phone to pay attention to him. Sentence 2. He was engrossed in his video games. Now that you know what the word engrossed means, let's try some vocabulary exercises. Pick the synonym for the word engross. Is it A. lost, B. captivate, C. bore, or D. disgust? The correct answer you should have chosen was B, captivate. Let's try another exercise. Pick the sentence that uses the word engross correctly. Is it A, he was engrossed with a TV show and turned off the TV? Or is it B, he was engrossed with his book and didn't want to stop reading it? The correct answer is B. Now that you know what the word engross means, try making your own sentence. If you want to further expand your vocabulary, you can try doing a vocabulary four square. You're going to take out a sheet of paper and fold it to make it four squares. In the middle of these four squares will be your vocabulary word. One box will have the definition. Another box, you can use the vocabulary word in a sentence. In another box, write a synonym for the word. And in the last box, draw a picture dealing with the word. That's all for our vocabulary word of the day. I hope you were engrossed by that lesson. Now let's get back into making inferences, shall we? An inference is an idea or conclusion based on evidence and reasoning. An inference is pretty much an educated guess. Now let's try some really simple examples. Let's say you go outside and you see somebody dressed in workout clothes and shoes. You also see that person stretching out. What can you infer about that person? You would probably infer that that person is about to exercise or work out. Let's try another simple example. Let's say you see somebody yawning and their eyes look all droopy. What can you infer about that person? You might have inferred that that person is sleepy. Here's one last simple example. Let's say you see somebody coughing and sniffling. What would you infer about that person? You might have inferred that that person is sick or not feeling well. Good job. Now let's move on to making inferences based on a text. Sadie, Jason yelled as loud as he could walking through the park. He shouted again, Sadie. He peeked in the bushes, checked behind the slides, and even under cars. He was tired and almost out of breath. The sun was about to set too. Right when he was about to give up, he became engrossed with the sight of a shiny object hanging on a swing. It was a leash. Jason couldn't give up then and shouted again, Sadie! What can you infer about Sadie? Who was she? Your most likely inference would be that Sadie was a dog or any other pet you might keep on a leash. How did I infer that? It was because Jason found a leash. And what do you keep on a leash? Usually dogs or pets. What inference can you make about Jason's actions? What was he trying to do? You might have inferred that Jason was looking for Sadie. How did I infer that? If you look at the evidence, Jason says Sadie's name while looking through the park. That one was pretty simple, right? Now let's go into something a little bit more difficult. This excerpt is from The Honest Truth About Fake News and How Not to Fall for It by Matthew Green, written on May 3rd, 2017. Impressionable young minds. Young people are among the most vulnerable and impressionable consumers of this kind of misinformation, according to a recently released study by Stanford's History Education Group. Researchers collected nearly 8,000 responses from middle school, high school, and college students, also known as digital natives, around the country who were asked to evaluate online information presented in tweets, comments, and articles. Overall, young people's ability to reason about the information on the internet can be summed up in one word, bleak, the report states. Our digital natives may be able to flip between Facebook and Twitter while simultaneously uploading a selfie to Instagram and texting a friend. But when it comes to evaluating information that flows through social media channels, they are easily duped. The researchers were consistently shocked by the number of students who couldn't effectively evaluate the credibility of the information they were presented with. Let's make some inferences based on the text. What do you think digital natives mean? Also, why do you think these young minds are so impressionable? Think about it. That's all I have for this lesson. Stay safe, everyone. Goodbye.
Did you know that by staying at home, you are less at risk for coronavirus, will help not make others sick in the community and your family, and help frontliners such as nurses, doctors, emergency responders, and more to be able to fight the virus?
But sometimes we have to leave our homes for important things such as food, medicine, and other essential items.
When you do go out, remember to practice social distancing.
Social distancing means making sure you keep the space between you and the people around you out in public. 6 feet apart is how far you should be from the people you do not know and do not live with you. Look out for stickers on the floor at stores to guide you. Don't forget to wear protective gear, such as your mask.
It is important to practice social distancing to protect ourselves and others who we may come in contact with when we leave our homes, such as grocery store workers, medical staff, and other people in our community who risk their lives so we can be safe and healthy.
If you do leave your house, practice decontamination when you get home. Some ways to practice this can be properly dispose or sanitize your mask. Leave your shoes and slippers outside. Wash your hands with soap and water for 20 seconds. Clean your items to disinfect them. Wash your hands again after or take a shower.
I stay at home for myself, my family, my friends, and for my community.
Coronavirus can be deadly. Stay at home.
Stop the spread.
Save lives.
Save lives.
Save lives.
Save lives.
Save
lives. When Kwamir Pan Irayan Kalikitisang Pachpene Naramas. Yema wewe ke selar mo yang kapu kono nara masakan ka school ke kesa menimbamkan rempich wono o menimbamkan wasan kousa metuache miminim o ira kesampalkan makumpan anane yi kolan stowa memoi moi o pachpene aram pasbenya makasampalkan yech kwasanga kan me openeng we kwa ni cleaning kan stowal laus towa chikichik wasame sabis ki take out ni bank kan wasame nechin woni wasan lopolop kan option government pon ban open and running to tong kan kokolache yech kwasakan me close disanga we in dining restaurant wasan sakau kan ni retail store kan wasan matong kan wasan kabakon kan ni chim kan o wasan exercise che kan yes yei me konen ki chai koros and open o kolatta prosen mawen wen kuam o wasan a chai koson kan ke ira value match minimin penne ki chai pang kak kalwe ti so mawach kalangan
Hi everyone, I'm Miss Pama, and today we are going to do some algebra. What is algebra? Algebra is a way of thinking about numbers and quantities. With algebra, we can solve problems even when we don't know all the values. These unknown numbers or values can be represented using variables, which are symbols or any lowercase letter, usually X, Y, or Z. You can use algebraic expressions to explain relationships between quantities. For example, her math grade increased by 6 points. Let G represent the math grade, G plus 6. Today, we are going to talk about algebraic expressions. Before we go over some examples, let's go over a few terms we should know. First, what is an algebraic expression? You should remember that a numerical expression includes numbers and operations. Remember that expressions have no equal signs. An algebraic expression is an expression that contains numbers, operations, and one or more variables. For example, x minus 7, 3x plus 4, and xy, or x times y. Is 3 plus 7 an algebraic expression? No, it is not. It is a numerical expression because it does not contain a variable. How about 3x plus 4 equals 10? Is that an algebraic expression? No, it's not. Because it has an equal sign, it is an equation. Let's go over the parts of an algebraic expression. Here we have the expression 3x minus 2y plus 7. A term is either a single number or variable, or numbers and variables multiplied together. Terms are separated by addition or subtraction signs. In our example, there are three terms. They are 3x, negative 2y, and 7. Next, variables. Remember what variables are? A variable is a letter or symbol that represents an unknown quantity. It's called a variable because it varies. It can change. Can you tell me what the variables are in this expression? That's right, x and y. The constant is the term with no variable. Things that are constant are things that don't change. No matter what the variable is, that constant will stay the same. Are there any constants in our expression? That's right, 7 is a constant. No matter what x or y is, 7 will always stay 7. The coefficient is the numerical factor of a term that contains a variable. The variable terms are 3x and negative 2y. Can you tell me what the coefficients are? Awesome! The coefficients are 3 and negative 2. In order to translate a verbal phrase into an algebraic expression, we need to know the key words or phrases that will help us identify what operation we are going to use. Here is a chart that will help us remember what these key words are. For addition, the keywords are add, plus, and, total, increase, more, sum, and together. The keywords for subtraction are take away, minus, less, reduce, remain, take from, fewer, take, difference, and how many more. The keywords for multiplication are multiply, times, product, multiplied by, groups of, lots of, doubled, and times table. And finally, the keywords for division, divided by, share, divide into, divisible by, group, each, share equally. Now let's practice. We can use the variable x to represent the unknown number, a number decreased by 7. The keyword is decreased, so what operation are we using? Subtraction. Great! A number decreased by 7 is x minus 7. 5 more than a number. The keyword is more than. What operation are we using? Addition. Awesome! Because 5 is more than the number, the expression will be x plus 5. Let's do two more. The quotient of 2 and a number. The keyword is quotient. What operation are we using? Division. The quotient of 2 and a number is 2 divided by x. Last one, and let's make this interesting. 8 more than triple a number. There are two keywords in this phrase. Can you tell me what they are? That's right, more than and triple. This means we are going to add 8 after multiplying 3 to the variable. The algebraic expression is 3x plus 8. Now let's do some word problems. When translating a verbal phrase into an algebraic expression, we do not need to solve. Just write the algebraic expression.
Step one is you have to decide what you want your variable to represent, because you've got a real world situation, so you've got to figure out what's your unknown. Step two, identify the key word, because that'll let you know what operation you've got to do. Add, subtract, multiply, divide, if you've got an exponent. The key word is what's going to give you a hint on that. And then the final step is to go ahead and write that expression. So remember those three steps. Even write them down if you want. You can even write them like a shortcut little note to yourself. That's going to help us work our way through all of these problems. Let's keep going. All right, example one. 3 more points than the other team scored. All right. Now, what I don't know in this case is how many points the other team scored. So that's what I'm going to let my variable represent. And you can pick any letter of the alphabet you want for your variable. It's up to you. A lot of times you'll notice that they'll choose a variable that kind of reminds them of the situation. So for example, the points the other team scored. Let me even catch that. It's the points the other team scored. I'm going to let P represent those points. So P is the points that the other team scored. And there were 3 more points than that team score. So you remember that more, that told you you were adding. So I have 3 more points than the other team. You translated that real world situation, 3 plus P. Or remember, you could have said P plus 3. Either one's fine. Okay? Let's try the next one. 4 years younger than Kendall. Okay. So what I don't know here is how old Kendall is. So that is what my variable is going to represent. I'm going to let K represent Kendall's age. That's my unknown. I have no clue how old Kendall is. But what I do know is I need to represent a situation of 4 years younger than Kendall. So think about younger, just in the real world. If you're younger than someone, then your age is less than theirs. So remember less than, that told us we were subtracting. So 4 years less than Kendall. Got Kendall's age, and I need 4 less than that. So I can represent that K minus 4, okay? Are you seeing how it's not that much different than translating expressions? You just have that little extra step of kind of interpreting the situation and deciding what your variable needs to represent.
That's all I have for you today. Stay safe, and I hope to see you next time.